One of the biggest bands to ever arrive on the London punk music scene was the Sex Pistols. One of the reasons behind their success was because of Sid Vicious. Simon John Ritchie, born May 10, 1957, played bass guitar in the Sex Pistols along with Johnny Rotten Lydon, Steve Jones, and Paul Cook. He got the nickname Sid Vicious after being bitten by Lydon's pet hamster Sid, with Simon Ritchie yelling about how the creature was very vicious. The Sex Pistols had Vicious in the band for a short period of time, but he was partially responsible for bringing the punk movement into the mainstream in the UK. With their drug use, anarchy on stage, and an attitude towards the monarchy and the Queen of England which was less than respectful, Sid Vicious and the band became anti-heroes to the punk movement. In a country as conservative as England, their insane hair and fashion styles, including the famous lock around Sid Vicious's neck, terrified and shocked the majority of the population. He joined the band in 1977, with their manager Malcolm McLaren famously quoting that if Johnny Rotten is the voice of punk, then Sid Vicious is the attitude. He certainly wasn't famous for his musical abilities. As a bass player, he had zero experience, and on the band's debut and only studio album, Nevermind the Bollocks, Here's the Sex Pistols, most of his parts were recorded by someone else. The album went to number one and platinum on the music charts. Sid Vicious was extremely difficult to handle in any capacity as a friend, musician, or significant other. His drug-fueled attitude and behavior only got worse when he met and became romantically entangled with Nancy Spungen. She was diagnosed with schizophrenia at 15 years old and got involved with Sid Vicious in London at the height of the band's fame. The press named her Nauseating Nancy for her outbursts and behavior towards them, and she and Sid had a very violent and heroin-fueled relationship. After the Sex Pistols disbanded in 1978, Sid and Nancy moved to New York and stayed at the Hotel Chelsea, where they got into a brutal drug-dependent lifestyle. On October 12, 1978, Nancy Spungen's dead body was found under the sink in the bathroom of their hotel room. She had a single stab wound to the abdomen, which killed her, and Sid Vicious was arrested and charged with second-degree murder. He pled not guilty and wasn't able to recall the events of the night clearly because of his heroin use. Sid Vicious never stood trial for the murder, as he died of an overdose on February 1, 1979. To this day, it's debated whether or not Sid Vicious killed the woman he claimed he loved, with many people saying he couldn't have or wasn't capable of the murder, and that she was either killed by someone else or had taken her own life. Sid Vicious, or Simon Ritchie's ashes, were scattered by his mother over Nancy Spungen's grave, where she is buried in King David Cemetery in Bensalem, Pennsylvania.